ঠিক আছে তো গুড আফটারনুন এভরিওয়ান টুডে ইজ আওয়ার টপিক অফ ডিসকাশন ইজ এক্সরেস ইন সার্জারি সো দিস এক্সরেস ইজ ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট ফর দ্য এক্সাম পারপাস এন্ড ফর দ্য ডে টু ডে প্র্যাকটিস রিগার্ডিং সার্জারি জেনারেল প্র্যাকটিস দিস এক্সরেস আর ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট for a basic identification of the disease or problem. So first start with the x-ray. So x-rays are many of two types, is a plain x-ray and the contrast x-ray. So plain x-ray is we'll take the x-ray without any contrast material. Contrast x-rays are usually taken after administration of contrast material. Contrast x-rays are barium swallow, barium melt, barium enema, the deep loop cholangiography, cholangiogram, then intravenous infography. So coming to the, today we will discuss about the plain X-rays. In the next class, we will discuss on the contrast X-rays. So starting with the plain X-rays, this is the chest X-ray, plain chest X-ray PA view. So when you see a plain X-ray, starting with in the plain X-ray we mainly see the bony skeleton, then some soft tissue shadow, then air. It is a in the X-ray air comes as a hyper this slightly blackish in color. And any calcification. So coming with the this one in the bony skeleton, first we see the in the this is a PA view X-ray, and in the bony first we see the bony skeleton. If you go by systematically or methodically, you see the this is the bony skeleton. This is the clavicle. Then we see the scapula. Then we see the rib one by one. This is the first rib. Then second rib. And likewise, we see the rib like that one. These are the ribs. We see any fracture, any deformity in the ribs. Likewise, in the opposite side, we see the ribs one by one like this. Next come to the mediastinum. In the mediastinum, we see the this is the in the trachea. Tracheal rings are not comes in the X-ray, but the column of air, which is column of air hyperlucency, blackish in color. You can see this is the trachea. Okay. Then in the we can see the shadow of the heart. So in the heart on the right side, here you can see the inner lower arteries, or this is the hilum of the lung. This is the right atrium. In the base, it is mainly formed by the right ventricle. In the left side, left atrial appendages. Left ventricle, this is the cardiac shadow. Now coming on the soft tissue. So this is the bronchoalveolar markings, the lung parenchyma. We can see both the side. And lastly, you can see the both dome of diaphragm and the cardiophrenic angle. This one is the cardiophrenic angle and this one is the costophrenic angle. So these are the basic things in a chest X-ray. So we generally take the chest X-ray PFO. But if the patient is debilitating or after trauma, we can take also AP view. If you can't mobilize the patient, so it can be AP view also. So here the exposure of this X-ray is not proper because the scapula is not seen properly in that area. So mainly you have to see the scapula properly, the clavicle. So this is a chest X-ray PA view. So in the left side we can see the bronchoalveolar markings, the lung parenchyma, but on the right side there is hyperlucency, there is no bronchoalveolar marking, and this is homogeneous hyperlucency. So this is the plain X-ray PA view, chest X-ray showing pneumothorax. So in that case, patient might have breathing difficulty, the oxygen saturation comes down. So in that case, we can do needle drainage of this air, and we can do intercostal drainage, tube drainage. So this type of pneumothorax occurs due to traumatic or maybe any tuberculosis, any rupture of bulla or any cyst. This type of pneumothorax can occur. So this is a plain X-ray chest X-ray PA view showing right-sided pneumothorax. Coming to the next X-ray, this is a plain X-ray of abdomen. The diaphragm is not showing here with pelvis. So there is no significant abnormality, but we can identify the bony skeleton, then soft tissue shadow. This is the air hyperlucency. So we can identify some organ and solid organ and holoviscous organ. This is for the identification. Okay, fine. Now this is the shadow with frustration. These are the frustration. This is the air shadow. So this is the transverse column, and these air shadows are of colon, meaning the splenic flexure of colon. Okay, and this is the shadow, another shadow of a solid organ of soft tissue. This is the left kidney. Okay, here again we can see this is another soft tissue shadow. Another soft tissue shadow. This is the right kidney. Again, we can see the hyperlucency contain AI with frustration. So this is the ascending column. And in the central part, there is a hyperlucency. So this part of the intestine, so if it is centrally located, it always is the small bowel. That is, small bowel is centrally located. And this is the bony pelvis, this is the femur. And it's a left supra-iliac joint, this one. And this is the, again, shadow, which is periphery. Colon, last one in the periphery. And small bowel in the central part. So this is the descending colon. So this is the basic identification of bony structure, soft tissue, AR shadow, and calcification. You can see here, plain X-ray. Or this is the shadow of a bladder. So this is another X-ray. This is a plain X-ray of the chest, PA view, along with upper part of abdomen. So we can see there is a bronchoalveolar markings. This is the proper exposure of the X-ray. Weak shoulder joint, involving the shoulder joint, scapula, everything. Here, X-ray is done properly. So what is this? This is the broad dome of diaphragm. The finding is that this is the plain X-ray of the chest, PA view, along with upper abdomen. So this, there is a hyperlucency suggestive of gas below the diaphragm and upper surface of liver. But there is also hyperlucency in the left side. So when you suspect there is a gas under diaphragm, always first, we will see the right side. Always we see the right side. If there is a gas under diaphragm, it is suggestive of holodiscus perforation. In the left side, there is a hyperlucency, AR shadow. This may be fundic gas shadow, and there is another shadow with a bit frustration. It may be colonic shadow. So when you go for holodiscus perforation, we see the mainly the right side, right dome of diaphragm, and if there is a gas under diaphragm on the right side, mainly. This is suggestive of holodiscus perforation. So this is a plain X-ray of a chest, PA view, along with upper part of abdomen, showing gas under diaphragm, suggestive of holodiscus perforation. Now, what are the causes of holodiscus perforation? Where the perforation occurs? So, perforation occurs due to peptic ulcer. This is like gastric perforation, duodenal perforation, perforation due to small intestine due to tuberculosis, any malignancy in the intestine, they may perforate. And there is an accumulation of gas in the gas under diaphragm. So this type of patient usually presents with pain abdomen. There is a distension of abdomen. There may be tachycardia, dehydration, guarding rigidity in the abdomen. So in this is a very surgical emergency, need urgent exploratory nephrectomy and primary closure of the perforation with omental patch with that. Okay, thank you. So this is another X-ray of a chest X-ray PA view. This is a plain X-ray, but there is a hyperlucency in the right room of under the right room of diaphragm. So this is the diaphragm. Okay, and there is another shell. This is also under the diaphragm with air fluid level. With air fluid level. So this is a fundic gas shadow. This is a fundic gas shadow. But in the right side, there is a gas under diaphragm. Is it? Viscous perforation. So, but here what happens? There is a obstruction. Obstruction. So this is a large bowel coming under the diaphragm and upper part of the liver. So this is a pseudo pneumopenitent, not actual gas under diaphragm. Because there is a frustration. So you should not confuse with the gas under diaphragm. In the gas under diaphragm, in the last, this is a homogeneous hyperlucency under the diaphragm above the liver. But in this X-ray, there is a frustration of a large bowel. So this is called Chilaiditi syndrome. So there is a large bowel between the upper part of the liver and the under the diaphragm. And presence of obstruction suggestive of large bowel. So this is a pseudo pneumoperitoneum. It's called Chilaiditi syndrome. But in case of this type of in the holoviscous perforation, there is a we have to examine the patient clinically. In perforation, there is a distension of abdomen, diffuse pain, guarding will be there, rigidity, tachycardia, like that. But in this case, there may be mild pain or without pain. So coming to another X-ray, plain X-ray abdomen. In the X-ray, in this X-ray, there is multiple air fluid level. Because this is the fluid, this is the horizontal line, like fluid, and there is a hyperlucency. This is air running out of time. There will be 10 minutes upgrade now to remove 40 minutes time. No, upgrading. What is it? Okay, fine. So, in that X-ray, we are getting the air fluid level. Okay, this is the air fluid level. Air fluid level we are getting. And that is a dilatation of bowel in this X-ray. So, in that bowel, we are getting this shadow. This is valvuli conibantis. This is due to the mucosal folds of small intestine, mainly the jejunum. So this is a complete involves the whole bowel diameter, one thing, and valvular conjunctivitis come one after another very frequently. So this one, one valvular conjunctivitis, another valvular conjunctivitis, this is another valvular conjunctivitis. These type of features present in small bowel, mainly jejunum. Okay, but here there is also a shadow, horizontal shadow, but it is incomplete. This is incomplete, and this shadow, one and another shadow is the part, not frequent. This is not complete and apart one from another. So this is a prostration suggestive of large bowel. So when there is an obstruction, we will get multiple airfluid level. If there is a two airfluid level, it may normal. But three and more than three airfluid level suggestive of obstruction. And in case of the diameter, if the small bowel diameter more than 3 cm, it is small bowel obstruction. In case of large bowel, if it is more than 6 cm, it is a large bowel obstruction. In case of dilatation, in case of sigmoid cone, if it is more than 9 cm, that is a obstruction. So there is a rule of 3, 6, and 9. 3, 6, 9 means small bowel more than 3 cm dilatation, that there may be obstruction. In large bowel more than 6 cm, large bowel obstruction. If the dilatation is more than 9 cm because of sigmoid column, it is suggestive of obstruction. Now, which part is obstructed, which bowel is dilated, it is very important. How can we diagnose this? It is a small bowel. In the small bowel, there is a jejunum, ileum. In case of large bowel, which part is dilated? So in case of small bowel, already seen, this is the valvular conjunctivitis. Valvular conjunctivitis, so which is complete and come one after another very frequently. This is a suggestive of jejunum. In case of large intestine, this shadow is of frustration, which is incomplete, come one after another. This is apart, not frequently comes. So this is a suggestive of large bowel. And one thing is important, the small bowel usually present in the central part of the abdomen, and the large bowel peripheral part of the abdomen. So one from valvular conjunctivitis suggestive of jejunal obstruction or jejunal dilatation. In the large bowel, there is a obstruction which is incomplete, comes is not frequent, lying apart, this obstruction. And in case of ileum, another essay is there. This is the dilatation of small bowel present in the central part of the abdomen, suggestive of small bowel, but there is no valvular conjunctivitis. It is characterless. It is characterless. So this might be ileum. So ileum, there is a very less or absence of valvular conjunctivitis, and this is a characterless present in the central part of the abdomen, suggestive of small bowel, mainly ileal obstruction or dilation. This is the another X-ray of plain X-ray of abdomen. It is most likely in supine position. So what is the importance of plain X-ray abdomen in supine position in case of obstruction? When you take the abdominal X-ray, we take in three views. One is left view, especially in standing position. one in supine view in the supine position, another is left lateral decubitus view. So what is the importance of taking an X-ray in supine position is that in supine position, what happens, the fluids come down, settle down. When patient lies in supine position, fluids settle down, then the air comes up. So in that case, you won't get any air fluid level. When you will take a X-ray in supine position. So in that case, in the supine position, we mainly get the part which is the part of the bowel which is obstructed or dilated. We can easily identify. This is the X-ray. Again, I am saying this is the X-ray of multiple plain X-ray abdomen. Showing multiple air fluid level in the central part of the abdomen with this type of valvular cornumentis suggestive of small bowel obstruction. Okay, fine. But in this X-ray there is no air fluid level because it is in supine position. But you can easily find out the bowel which is obstructed, the part of the bowel which is obstructed. So there is a numbers of valvular cornumentis suggestive of jejunal segment is involved. This is another X-ray showing fundic gas shadow with multiple air fluid level. So this is of intestinal Shall I continue the kidney part?
No, sir.
What